పరిత్యజ్య
మామేకం
శరణం వ్రజ అహం త్వాం సర్వ పాపేభ్యో మోక్షయిష్యామి మా శుచః. So what is the meaning of this shloka? Sarva dharman parityajya. Somebody said? Sit down.
Come this side.
Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam sharanam raja. Okay? Dharma means a right thing to do. Okay? What is the right thing to do in a rightful way, in a righteous way, is called dharma. We have a desire in life. I want this, I want that, I want that, right? I want to get a good mark, I want to get a good job. All the desires are there. The desires have to be fulfilled in a right way. If you do it in wrong way, it will cause suffering for you and suffering for everybody, right? So what way if I do, it will be good for all and good for me, is called dharma. So dharma is about action. Sarva dharman parityajya means Shri Krishna is saying, drop all actions, then what will I do? If I drop all actions, what will I do? So the drop actions here, when I want Krishna, when I want God, if I want cooking, or if I want to eat food, I should not drop actions, I have to go eat food. Okay, if I have to go to school, I have to go to school. So Krishna says, if you want to get me means what? Krishna, the Lord. Then you have to drop everything, you have to surrender. Right? So what is this surrender? Okay. The Lord, Bhagwan, is like a mother. Okay. So the mother is a, the child is playing. Okay. The child is making a lot of noise. So mother will come and give a car, play. The child is happy, play for some time. Then child will say, no, I want this thing, what is that, bat. So mother will give the bat. Like that, mother will keep on giving what child is asking. So what is the purpose of mother? Why mother is giving? Don't disturb me, you play. Okay, mother wants to focus on the work. Don't disturb me, you play. Whatever you want to play. So now the child is played with a car, without a baba, this thing. And now child is not, now child will start crying. I want mommy, I want mother, I want mother, I want mother, he'll start crying. Okay? Now what mother will do? What she'll give? Take a chocolate. No, I want mother. Then what she'll do? Then she will come. Then she'll pick up the baby. Right? So like that Bhagwan, you keep asking Bhagwan, he will keep on giving like a chocolate. Okay? He'll give you a car. Don't disturb me. Oh, bat. Oh, okay, you want this thing. That's all the small kids. So big kids will ask something. Big kids will ask, I want a promotion. Okay, I want a good buddhi for my wife, or buddhi for my husband, or a good marks for my daughter. Okay, Bhagavan will say, take. It's like giving a chocolate. Mother giving a chocolate. So we keep on asking God many things in life, and we work for that also. Okay? That's what is called dharma. We'll work in the rightful way also. We don't want to do it wrong way. But have we asked God, I want you? I want to be one with God. Okay? I want to one with God, then you cannot do anything. Right? Then you have to stop doing everything. Right? You have to surrender to God. Stop doing everything. Stop doing everything is playing with the car, football, and this, that. I want that, I want that. Because as long as you keep on saying, I want this, I want that, the mother will keep on giving you. The God will keep on giving you. So that your attention is elsewhere. But if you say, I want God, I want you only, then don't play with anything. I sit. I want God. Then what? God has no choice. He will come running to you. Sarva dharman Parityaja. Dharman Parityaja means Karman Parityaja. Doing everything, dropping it. Sarvat. Mamekam Sharanraja. I only surrender to you. Okay? So surrendering to God. Now means I don't want to do anything. I want God only. With that desire, if you see it, the God will come into your life. Mamekam Sharanamaja. Aham Tvam Sarva Papipu. Then God will remove, God will free you from all papa. Papa means whatever causes suffering. Okay? What causes suffering? I want this, I want this, I want this. Why we want, I want this, I want this, I want this in life? Because there is a feeling of inside this, I am not, I need something. I am not happy with what I have. Right? There is a desire. There is a shortcoming inside. Why there is a shortcoming? Why there is a desire inside us? Because something is missing in our life. Okay? We don't know the missing thing in our life is called God, which you don't know. That people don't know. So they have so many desires in life because they don't know what they miss is God. Nothing wrong in having desire. Okay, I want a promotion, I want to work, all those things are there. But these desires are coming because I want means there's a shortcoming in me. Okay? The shortcoming in me is people don't know. They think that if I get a promotion, I'll be happy. Okay, he gets a promotion. Then he sees that fellow has got more salary. He's unhappy. Right? He got a promotion, there some increment came, so that fellow has got more, unhappy, right? So everything what we do, some amount of happiness will be there, some amount of unhappiness will be there. Is there a situation where we'll get be all happy all the time? Anything which gives us happiness, always given eventually gives unhappiness, okay? Somebody is happy, okay? I get a good job. The moment he gets a good job, he is unhappy because he has to work too much. For the salary, he has to work 12 hours a day. He is unhappy. So getting a job is happiness, but working is unhappiness. So what happens is in our life, sugar and sand is mixed. Happiness and unhappiness comes here. But I want happiness only. Is it possible? That's possible only when the God is in your life. When God, when you are one with God, then only it's possible, otherwise it's impossible. But most of the people don't understand this. They don't understand that what is missing in my life is God, they don't understand. But they understand in some way. Oh God, please give me promotion. Oh God, please give me good marks for my daughter, she has not studied. So God has to come and write the examination, that's okay. Okay? So we have so many demands from God. This is like asking mother, give me toy, give me chocolate, give me this thing and all. Then God also will keep giving sometimes. Sometimes he doesn't give also. Okay, let him cry. Okay, cry. But what people don't understand is that this problem I don't have something, comes from mine, deep inside. Because I am missing God in my life. No, I am not missing God in life. Then where is God in your life? Oh, in puja room. Okay, see. Morning you do puja and after that close safely, lock the door. Right? That is not the place for God. Okay? God's place is my heart. Okay? God's place is my mind. My heart, my mind, everything should be filled with God. Then there is a happiness. Because God is called happiness. So people don't ask for it. Right? They keep on asking something from God. So God says, if you want me, okay, what is required? Stop doing all nonsense and say, I want God. Then God will come in your life. Okay. Then Sarvat Mamekam Sharanabhaja. Come surrender to me. Surrender to me. Understand your limitation. What is the limitation? We think that I'll get happiness by doing this. I'll get happiness. So we'll have to realize that happiness doesn't come by doing anything. Happiness comes only by realizing God. Okay? So that doesn't mean that tomorrow you should not go to school. No, you should go to school, you should study well, you should get a good job. All those things are fine. But don't confuse that will give you happiness. That is required for your life. Okay? That you have to do. You have to go to school, you have to study well, all those things. But happiness, only full happiness comes from God. That you have to understand. Right? So we start working for happiness and thinking that happiness will come for it.
Don't worry. Work for your life, work for service, all those things you do. But working for happiness is something not right. Okay? Happiness will come only from realizing God. When your whole life is filled with God, you are happy. Okay. So in market you can purchase everything. Right? You can go and buy something. But happiness, we think we are getting happiness, but along with happiness, unhappiness comes. Okay? So work. Do well in the examination. Perform well. Do well in life. Okay? Do your duties. Follow the dharma. But never confuse. That will give you happiness, permanent happiness. It will give some little bit, choti-choti, little bit happiness it will give. But little bit happiness, it will give unhappiness also. Okay? So don't confuse that happiness and unhappiness comes from work. Pure happiness comes only from God. That is the message. Right? Surrender to me means, surrender means what? You have seen surrender? Somebody holding gun, surrender. So what is the meaning of surrender? Surrender means whatever you want to do. Okay? I am at your mercy. Right?
To realize that this is all done by God and I'm just
To realize that your everything is God only. Doing the entire universe is run by God. I am just the instrument of God. Okay? Right? I am the instrument of God. As per the God's will, I am doing something. See, for example, how do you tell you are an instrument of God?
Because whatever I am doing, it's not that I am doing at my will. It's already destined to be done. And it's just that I just have to sit back and just let things happen.
If you sit back, how the things will work?
Means like, it's not like thinking that I am doing it, but God
is doing it. For example, even to do a simple act like lifting my hand, my brain has to work. My eyes have to operate. My tongue has to operate. My stomach has to work. My heart has to beat. Who is doing all this? That is God. The God is powering this machine, this end. So in that way, everything is by the power of God I am doing. But people start thinking, I am only doing something, I am great. Okay, they don't understand the power behind this greatness. Every watt of yours is depending on God. Okay? If your kidney is not operating, gone case. If your heart is not operating, gone case. If your eyes are not operating, so all this is the power of God. So every single breath, now the breath is going inside. Next moment it goes out. It says, Tata, bye-bye, I don't come. Gone case. Okay, is there somebody, can you force the breath to inside? It'll come. These are all power of God. Okay? Morning sun is rising. There's a wind, right? The water is there. The whole place is there. Everything is God. Everything is. So everything is provided to us by God. I have to do my work. What is assigned to me, I have to do it well. Okay? So understanding that I am not the doer. You are the power behind my action. You are my strength. So when God is my strength, then my work will become beautiful. Right? If I start thinking, I am only the kumbhalakai, badnekai, I am only doing great. Surrender means understanding that everything is done by the power of God. Right? Like for example, this fan. The fan gets electricity. Okay, if electricity is there, fan will rotate. But fan will start thinking, you know, what brand fan I am? I rotate so well. It doesn't know whether electricity, it doesn't work. Right? But it has to rotate. It has to give air. It has to blow air. The work is yours, but power is God's. Okay? That you understand. That's called surrender. Okay? So God, you are the power behind my action. Show me the right way. The right things may happen through me. Service may happen through me. That's called surrender. Then, I want God only. That's called sarvadharma parityajya. So I want God only. Then how do you, when you say I want God only, you stop doing everything. Okay? sit silently, sit silently, and sit silently with a desire to be one with God. Then the power of God will take you closer to Him. Sarva Dharma Paritya. This you don't have to do. This you do sometime in a day. That's called meditation. Okay. Sarva Dharma Paritya. Then in meditation time you should not do any activity. Meditation means surrendering, sitting silently, accepting the power of God to show you the higher. Show the power. That's called Sarva Dharma Paritya Mamekam Sharanam. Aham Tvam Sarva Papebhyo. Papa means something which causes you trouble, disturbs you. Right? What disturbs you? Small things disturb in life. Okay? Right? So all those things God removes and gives you pure happiness. Mamekam Sharanam Raja means surrender to me. Surrender to whom? Krishna. The Krishna is in my heart. Krishna is my Atma. Don't think that Krishna is sitting somewhere. Krishna is in my heart. Okay, Krishna is in my mind. Krishna is in my power in my. So surrender to Krishna in your heart. Then you become free from suffering. This is the meaning of the shloka. Any questions? Clear to everybody? You came just now. Any doubts? Okay. Next shloka.